Ah, Florida, you've given us so much. Gatorade, sunscreen, key lime pie, but nothing compares to the sweet, sweet nectar that is the state's signature cocktail. That's right, I'm talking about the one, the only, the
rum. That's it. I'm seriously not doing any more liquor runs until you use up some of what we have. This is insane. I don't have room for all this. I don't even know. I don't have room for my Instant Pot.
Hey everyone, it's Jeff from Tiki Drinks at Home. So just want everyone to know there's no need to panic. The booze is okay. I mean, no more room for booze. That's crazy talk. Booze is like Jell-O. There's always room for more. And speaking of more booze, today we're taking a look at Florida's signature cocktail, a fruity yet boozy tropical drink that put a little place called the Holiday Isle Tiki Bar in Isla Mirada, Florida on the map way back in 1972. So legend has it that bartender John Ebert, or Tiki John as he was known, was also asked to get rid of some old liquor, and as a result, ended up creating a cocktail using rum, banana liqueur, blackberry liqueur, fruit juices, and grenadine. The legendary Rum Runner was born, named after the rum runners that inhabited the Florida Keys in the early 1900s. Now, the taste of this drink is not the only great thing about this cocktail. The recipe itself is really easy to remember. So the Rum Runner is made up of equal parts of pretty much all the ingredients. So if you're looking for a standard size drink, use 1 ounce. If you're looking for a super size, bump that to 1.5 ounces or 2 ounces per ingredient. There's been many variations on the Rum Runner recipe over the years, so feel free to experiment. But just remember, in order to call it a Rum Runner, you need to use the original ingredients. That is, light rum, dark rum, blackberry liqueur, banana liqueur, pineapple juice, orange juice, grenadine, and top it off with some 151 rum.